Hi, आप हैं श्रुति के साथ on my second nature. And इस month we are going to cover how to rewrite your story. If you're listening to me and going, एक minute, I don't want to rewrite my story, I don't need it. Well, neither do I. But we don't know better till we don't actually talk to an expert and they tell us in how and what ways can we actually better our life and rewrite our story better. So while you still might know कि हाँ खुद की कहानी कैसे लिखनी है, लेकिन कैसे उसे बेहतर लिख सकते हैं, that's somewhere I think there's always scope for growth. So this month I'm going to talk to Alpa Kapadia Telly, who is a coach. She's not just an ordinary coach. She is someone who's certified in leadership and as a life coach, trainer and motivational speaker. She's the founder of Ignite the Spark. And us program ke andar, unki expertise aur zyada pata lagti hai as a transformational coach. Her clientele is a quite an impressive mix actually of finance, FMCG companies, banks and consultants. Interesting, right? So such a person, what take will she have to give to you and me to improve our everyday life? This month, I've asked her to create specially the special set of, you know, topics that she'd like to discuss from her experience with all these different sectors with whom she works and the kind of people she helps. Hame kya wo apne experiences sikha sakti hain? So let's get to it. Let's chat with her and find out what she's got in store for us. So let's say hello to Alpa Kapadia Telly. Hello, Alpa. How are you?
Hello, Shruti. I'm very good and very happy to be with you today.
Ah, superb. So I must tell our viewers right now that Alpa and I go a long way back. Hum log college mein ikatthe, you know, padte the in Bombay. And she was like this one dynamic person even back then. But never did I think, Alpa, that today we're going to be sitting face to face, chatting about you being a life coach and teaching us about all these wonderful things that this month you are going to. So thank you for being part of this.
You are most welcome. I also never thought that we'll be sitting across like this. And this dynamic person that you see, which I've always been, I have to tell you that I lost it in the middle somewhere and I had to get it back. So I went through that journey of getting back and I came back, I think, far, far stronger than I went down.
And that's why that going downhill was super important. Because otherwise, ye journey kahan se aati?
Authenticity nahi aati hai.
Yes, journey yes. So I have been reading up a lot about you. Firstly, I must say, well done. Like you are like fully like crazy stuff you're doing, which is like totally inspirational. And the more you get into it, the more you're like, yeah, this is so good. I wish I could also learn this. And I'm specifically talking about your transformational journey and how you are, you even let's say label yourself as an inner transformational catalyst. So tell me more about it. How did this thing about being a life coach start? How did this specific genre, why?
Yeah, so such a good question. You know, everything in my life has happened so organically, and I was working, you know, I was heading learning and development, leadership development for Godrej before I quit. And then I had my kids and I realized, yeah, I don't want to go back to politics in the company. You know, when you go higher up, then for politics, hi politics hota hai.
Correct.
So I didn't have the stomach for it. I said, this is not cut out for me. I don't want to leave my kids and go do this.
Yeah.
And I was wondering also personally at that time, I was going through that phase, which I told you, right? I was like in a flux. I was emotionally, financially, spiritually quite depleted.
Right.
And I said, kuch to karna padega, boss. This is not happening.
Right.
You know, like I'm meant for more.
Yeah.
So then I reached out to a friend who's a coach and I said, hey, listen, I need you to coach me because I'm going through some stuff. And she said, listen, I love you and I know you. Want you to do the coaching certification program. तो मैंने ये भी हाँ बोल दिया. मैंने कहा ठीक है. वी वर इन जुलाई, प्रोग्राम सितंबर में था. बट एट दैट टाइम समथिंग हैज हैपेंड. आई सेड ओके, आई विल डू इट. एंड सितंबर केम, आई वाज नॉट वर्किंग एंड आई सेड आई वांट टू डू दिस प्रोग्राम. लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम फैमिली, क्या करोगी, इट वाज एन एक्सपेंसिव प्रोग्राम ऑब्वियसली. एंड आई वाज लाइक, आई एम डूइंग इट, दैट्स इट, यू नो, आई जस्ट डिड इट. शुड यू वोंट बिलीव, दोस 4 इयर्स वाज, दोस 4 डेज वाज सो ब्यूटीफुल. दे एक्चुअली चेंज्ड माय होल पर्सपेक्टिव. They completely began my transformation journey. And then I knew that, oh, I have to be a coach. I have to do this for the rest of my life.
Right.
But now when I meet other coaches, they are like doing analysis. They are examining 15 different coaching schools and all of that. Mere saath kuch nahi hua. So I always say that coaching called me. I didn't call coaching. So coaching to happened in my life. Okay?
Right.
And at that time, I was in this phase where I was लो ऑन एनर्जी, राइट? सो आई वॉज ब्लेमिंग एवरीबडी एल्स कि बाकी सब इतने गड़बड़ है इसलिए मेरा लाइफ गड़बड़ है. तो कंप्लीट विक्टिम कॉन्शियसनेस.
Yeah,
it happened,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
And then as I started coaching and I set my inside world right, the same people in my outside world turned around. So then I realized it was not them, it was me.
That is a very big learning to have.
Tough pill to swallow.
Yeah,
that it
yeah.
was not because of them, it was because of you. But I swallowed that pill and then I realized inner transformation. So that is the key, you know. It's not that the people are doing things to us, it's our energy which is attracting people to us. So if you fix the energy, automatically wo magnet achha hi cheez khichega.
Correct.
Secret key lies in the inner transformation.
Wow, I love how you put the secret element in, because you know, all of us with this law of attraction and this whole thing, you know, but say I think about 20 years back when the secret, the book came, and generally as a concept when it came out, everyone was like, oh my God, you know what I'm thinking, my thoughts, my everything, that's attracting. So going forward with the work that you do, and how you've so beautifully said that once you change the energy within you, the way you are perceiving the outer world, naturally aapki bahar ki duniya badal jayegi, right? But the question is, itna easy nahi hota. Not everybody goes through major life-altering changes. And why must we wait for a trauma to happen isse pehle ki hum kuch badal lein, right? So which is where you come in the picture and I come in the picture. So let's begin with energy. According to you, say we're going through a day, do you think it's important on a daily way to change our energy, or do you suppose it's a practice that must happen generally and our days will naturally change? Like for an absolute noob, somebody jo aaj pehli baar, you know, sun rahe hai aur keh rahe hai, ek minute, what are these women talking about? So can you give me an example so that we can, you know, power through into this topic and start discussing it?
Yes, absolutely. I have just the example for you. So I don't like to complicate people and, you know, give them complicated concepts. I'm a big reader, so I know all the concepts. But sikhane mein na samajh nahi aata. So I have this simple way I explain energy. I even explain this energy to my kids. So it's that simple. Yeah. So imagine you're playing you're playing Temple Run. Okay, now you're running, running. Subway Surfer, you're gathering points along the way, right? So as you're gathering points along the way, you are adding energy to yourself.
Right.
Now, usually behind you, there is a monster who is running behind you to take away your energy.
Correct.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Those are your energy leaks in life. If you have more energy than you have gained, you have won at life. If you have died because you have been, enough energy has been taken away from you, you've lost the game. So that is the whole energy game of life. If you have gained more energy than you have lost, you have won. If you have given away more energy than you have gained, you have lost. And that is really the whole game of energy that we are playing in our lives.
How beautifully put, and so simply.
So simply. However, there are different things, like at a daily level. So every day there are some things which we need to do which give us energy, you know, which nourish us, which nurture us.
Correct.
To just sustain our day well.
Yeah.
However, तुम कितना भी अपने आप को नरिश और नर्चर कर लो, बट इफ योर माइंड इज ऑलरेडी इन अ नेगेटिव माइंडसेट, तो फॉर एग्जांपल यू हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन ऑन द रोल कि यार लाइफ तो एकदम बेकार है और मैं एकदम बिचारी टाइप हूँ या बिचारा टाइप हूँ, सो दैट थॉट विल ईट इन टू द होल डे.
राइट.
नाउ यू मे ईट द बेस्ट फूड एंड हैव द बेस्ट केल सैलड्स एंड द ग्रीन स्मूदीज, बट इफ योर माइंड इज रॉटन, नथिंग इज गोइंग टू हेल्प.
करेक्ट. Correct.
So that energetic, even at a being level, like, you know, who are you being as a person? When you wake up in the morning, are you like, kya yaar, kya bekaar din uthi hu? Or are you waking up like, okay, today's a new day, let's give it our best, right?
Right, right.
So strategy level pe bhi thoda energy manage karna padta hai, and at a more tactical level as well.
Okay, lovely. So then let's get deeper into it, like how you have nicely divided the two things. Ke ek to hai jahan pe hum energy gather kar rahe hain, ek hai jo hamari energy leaks hain. So what are these energy leaks? Like, see, it's easy to understand when you're giving an example of a temple run. But in practical life, what are these energy leaks?
Very good question. So in practical life, Shruti, the energy leaks look like toxic relationships. hanging around with people who are negative, who are complaining, who are cribbing about the salary raise, who are cribbing about the boss, simply working too much screen time, not really taking time out to see what's important for you, not having your regular intake of water or not taking care of yourself.
Yeah.
It also means stuck in a situation or a relationship or a career that you don't like, that is not aligned to you. So now, you know, your heart is really set on being a singer and you're in this super analytical job where you're an investment banker.
Right.
And you're going to your job to pay the bills. But when you hear somebody sing, you're like, I wish I could sing like that.
Right.
You know,
right.
So these are the larger choices you make in life, which is, okay, I'm going to be earning this job. And you can be stuck there your whole life, but still you're not going to be happy. So energy leaks are basically any actions, decisions, thoughts, and beliefs that you have, which are not in alignment. So whether you are stuck in a relationship which you're not liking, stuck in a job which you're not liking, or you have people around you which you just cannot stand.
Yeah.
The biggest energy leak for us is negative thoughts. When we have negative thoughts, they drain us. Second is stressful situations. You know, a situation which is like, say, a review with your boss, a difficult conversation with your partner, or something with a friend which is telling them that they are sending too many WhatsApp messages.
Yeah.
You know, things like that. So stressful situations.
Yeah.
Third is toxic relationships. Relationships which are emotionally abusive, physically abusive, which are degrading for you, but you still hang on to them because it's become a part of your identity.
Correct.
Fourth is not taking care of yourself, not having good food, good thoughts, lack of self-care.
Right, yeah. Right.
Fifth is victim consciousness, thinking that no matter what happens, the world is against me. And if you're going to think like that, trust me, yeah, nobody can help you.
Yeah, yeah.
So some people just, you know, anything you do, they will find a way to be victimized in that situation. So fifth is victim consciousness. Sixth is people-pleasing tendencies. When you are trying to please others, get people's approval, get them to like you, it's going to completely drain your energy because you are fueling them. Yeah,
right.
That's the sixth part. Seventh is societal conditioning. Are ye kar sakte ho, ye nahi kar sakte ho, ye karo, wo karo, artist mat bano, singer mat bano, you know, job karo. These kind of conditionings basically is a big energy leak.
Alpa, what I'm noticing is all these are very practical things. Like, you know, they're very practical things. They are everyday things. And there are many of these things which we can't really run away from. It's not possible to put these things on a back burner saying, okay, I'm not going to allow my energy to be drained by these factors, because these factors are staring at us in our face constantly. So what do we do in that case?
Such a good question, Shruti. And the reason is we all have got ourselves to this place where we are being people pleasing, where we are allowing relationships to be toxic and not doing anything about it.
Yeah.
That is why the work I do, that is why, you know, Transformation Catalyst. You have to start from the being state.
Right.
So the question to ask yourself is, we all have to deal with this. We have to deal with stressful situations. They are going to come.
Right.
But the secret and the key question here, the golden question, is who are you being as you are doing what you are doing? Yeah. So I have to face a stressful situation with my boss, for example. I have a review coming up.
Right.
And my hike depends on that. And my house EMI depends on that. Now, it is a stressful situation. But can I go in sorted knowing I've done my best? Or do I have to spend 1 week without sleep, not eat, get myself riled up into a mess before I have a conversation?
So how does one change
your hand?
So how does one change that habit?
So first thing is the awareness. How are you even aware that this is happening to you, right?
Correct.
Most of us are on the hamster's wheel. We are just running, 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 and there's no time to stop and say, really, am I happy with what I'm doing? Do I really need to reach office at 9 a.m. sharp? Do I have to leave at 9 p.m.? Do I have to do the FaceTime? We don't even think about it, you know?
Yeah.
Even if we are in a relationship, we don't really think of the minute anybody says we need to talk, there's a lot of tension around it. Oh, what will be now? Are it's okay. You know, we have to have these conversations and we have to be truthful with ourselves.
I think half the time, this conversation of let's have the talk is also like a media created thing. Okay, ab itni filmon mein dekh liya hai that the moment somebody says, oh, let's have the talk, it's a mandatory way ki are shock reaction hona hi chahiye. Actually, ho sakta hai shock na feel ho.
Total fight or fight ho jata hai. Wo amygdala is, you know, all over the place. So yeah, totally. So one thing is awareness, yaar, ki yaar kya ho raha hai, you know, to just be aware, am I really happy? Asking yourself this question.
Right.
A very good way to start awareness, Shruti, is journaling.
Okay.
So just write to yourself, you know, ki achha, what am I feeling right now? What did I get triggered by? What am I grateful for today? What are the priorities in my life right now? You know, where should my energy really be going? So awareness is one.
Right.
Next is honesty with yourself.
Hmm.
A lot of times we fool ourselves. So you ask somebody, how are you feeling? And they be like, oh, I am fine. And they are telling themselves that because the minute they say they are not fine, they have to act.
Correct.
And they don't want to act.
Yeah.
So you will do everything else to lie to yourself and to the world that sab kuch theek hai. Sab kuch changa hai. All well. And you completely bypass that, yaar, kuch ho bhi raha hai, you don't look at it.
Correct.
So radical awareness, radical honesty. And the third then is the willpower to do the work. So saying, okay, yaar, I know if I get honest with myself, it's going to be tough.
Yeah.
So suddenly if I have to tell my partner, you know what, I'm just not happy in this relationship, or I have to tell my boss, I need to leave, or I need another role. This is just not working for me.
Yeah.
It's going to be tough.
Yeah.
But then having the willpower inside of you to reach out and say, you know, whatever it is, I'll pay the price. But I want to be aligned. So that is a spark which has to be ignited in you, where you say, bus, abhi enough. I want that alignment, and whatever price I have to pay, no, I'll pay.
Right.
Then only can you start doing the work of self-love, where you can start taking care of yourself.
So tell me, does that happen with you often? Do you come across a lot of clients of yours who basically can see all the things wrong within, you know, things that they want to change, but that acceptance factor, you know, how, like you said, that spark that needs to be ignited, that, okay, I'm going to do whatever it takes. Sometimes, you know, we tell ourselves, nahin, it's okay. Itna koi emergency nahi hai. Hamein nahi zarurat hai utna low pe girne ki, that we need to bring that change. We'll just adjust to whatever is going on.
Yeah.
So what do you tell to those clients of yours? How do you deal with that specific moment? Because I know for a fact that बहुत सारे लोग जब भी सुन रहे होंगे, they be like, यार हमारी life ठीक है, हमें इतना बदलने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, ठीक है तो बहुत अच्छी बात है, लेकिन अगर ठीक नहीं है, तब भी we, you know, tell ourselves कि ठीक है. At that point, what's the question we should be ask ourselves?
So, you know, the best performing people in the world, okay, now whether you take, you know, Federer or Phelps, Michael Phelps, all the biggest Olympic athletes, whether you see Sania Mirza or, you know, every single person, Saina Nehwal, anybody you take will have a bevy of coaches behind them. Because this idea that coaching is to fix the problem is actually bullshit. Am I allowed to say that word?
Well, now we've said it. We'll see how it goes.
This whole idea that, you know, coaching is only, like, this is a very little Indian mentality also, a taboo hai. As if tum therapist ke paas ja rahe ho, so you know your life is in a mess. It's not like that. It's for people who want to do more with their lives. They don't want to be stuck in average, mediocre, chalo, chala liya, you know, this is okay, that is okay. So people who want to rise above mediocrity, they are going to need support, physical support, mental support, spiritual support. There's nothing bad about it.
Right,
you know?
Right.
But I meet many people like this. They're like, haan, theek hi hai, matlab life aisi kaisi to thodi na koi problem hai. So earlier I had this thing because I am wired to see potential. So when I see somebody, no, I will see them for what is possible for them.
Right.
And then when I see them with little droopy shoulders, there's no shine in their eyes. Their movements are, I can make out just from the body language that they are not happy with where they are in their life.
Right. Right.
But the minute you start questioning them, they're like, nahin, it's okay. They're in denial.
Yes. Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And what I have learned to do is I have learned to leave them where they are, because nature will knock them off enough to get them to a point. So today, if they're not doing something about it, it's not going away. nature will hit you again on the head.
Correct.
And it's because every pain is a sign.
Yeah.
Pain is just a sign that you need to change something. Absolutely. Pain is not the villain, right? Mm. It's just telling you, hello, I need attention. Can you please give me attention?
Right.
So the minute you address it and change it, it will change. But if you're going to be in denial, then I can't help you. So I zip up and I say, yeah.
Okay.
And then after 6 months, they will call me and say, I want to start. Or sometimes they call me after 2 years also. That I want to start now, like tomorrow.
Sabki growth journey alag hoti hai. So when they come around that curve on their growth journey, they will be like, hello, Alpa, how are you? I want to connect.
But you know, some people have the courage. Like now, some people have the courage. They want to do more with their life. Like a woman, like say you want to do something more with your life.
Yeah.
I had enough. I didn't have to work per se. But I was just not happy sitting at home. My vision is so big. It's calling me every day. If I'm not working on it, it's like knock, 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 knock. Hello, what is it? What is it? So I had to do it. And I want to fulfill my vision. Yeah.
Correct.
Sapne aate the, you know, jab tak main kaam nahi kar rahi thi, I would dream. It would not let me rest. So when you have that, what to do?
Yeah.
When you have that, you just have to get the help that you need.
So
what is wrong with that? Yeah, I feel. What is wrong with getting help? You know, Indians have this problem with getting help. I want to know
not
today.
Not just Indians. I think this issue is there worldwide. I think it's more a conditioning issue, which also we're going to discuss in one of the episodes this month.
Yes, because
I think this way of thinking is a very deep-rooted conditioning issue. And usko bhi target karenge, pura aise, like properly we're going to deal with it. But coming back to energy, as we had started today, talking about the leaks especially and how to plug the leaks. So let's go towards that if you can give us one example, which we can sit here, like, you know, sit away from you, but we can apply it to any situation and see that when we plug that leak, how did it help our energy? So is there some exercise that you can help us with?
Exercise is actually different for each person. It really depends on where you are, but I think the principles remain the same.
Right.
So the principle really is, if there is something in your life which you are lying to yourself about, stop lying about that to yourself. So radical honesty with yourself, you know, the willingness to say, you know what, kitna bhi kar lo na, main nahi hu khush. Nahi hu khush is shaadi mein, nahi hu khush is job mein, nahi hu khush is jagah mein, is country mein, is city mein, whatever it is, you know, which is your thing. I'm not happy, and to accept. Hi, yaar, theek hai. Hai problem. How are you? I'm fine. No. You know, that's, I'm accepting it, that I have a problem. Theek hai. Okay, so now what? Then stay with it. I'm not saying tomorrow you have to go and file for divorce or put in your papers or, you know, shift countries, nothing like that. Just stay with it. Then start working on yourself inwards. How do you do that? Make a list of your dream life. Everybody has a different vision, Shruti. Your vision is different from mine.
Correct.
There's no right or wrong.
Correct.
But just say, what is the biggest, boldest dream I have for my life? If I could have it my way, every way, how would my life look like?
Right.
Put that down. You know, just accept it that, haan yaar, ye hai mera dream. Most of the time, Shruti, we don't even voice our dream because we feel log hasenge. Because we are so far from it, ke, you know, matlab kya hai? So accept, be honest with yourself, accept what is your dream. After that, start taking care of yourself. So ensure that you are filling yourself with energy. So I'll give you an example, like, you know, when I had two small kids and I wanted to start my business, which was literally like a third baby year. So how do I find the time? Because whole day is so going in all of this, right?
Correct.
So I made a commitment. I would get up in the morning. So I started getting up in the morning at 4:30 or 5. I did that for 6 months, 8 months. I started chanting. I started doing my spiritual practices. I started taking a walk, basically taking better care of myself. I stopped being the people pleaser. And I said, no, boss, this is my time. So if you are having these habits in your life, which are people pleasing tendencies, avoiding a conflict. Now, even if you're avoiding a conflict, it's not going away.
Yeah.
It's only being stored as resentment or anger. It's not going away anymore.
Correct.
So have that difficult conversation. If you realize you are saying, okay, yeah, let's go out for dinner, when actually you want to sit and do some work, have the courage to say, no, you know what? I will not take it today. Not even I can't. I will not be making it today. I can't is a very helpless thing to say. So don't say I can't. No, so I will not be making it today. Sit and prioritize yourself.
Right.
So prioritize yourself, take care of your health. Bigger decisions arrive at them. So don't try and do it all at one go.
Yeah.
Fill yourself up. Fill your cup with self-care, good food, good exercise, meditation, journaling, connecting with yourself. And from that space, allow yourself to take the bigger decisions.
Nice.
Which is about your marriage, your relationship. But yeah, start small.
Yeah, whatever the bigger thing. It could be something as simple as losing weight. It could be anything. But, you know, it doesn't have to be something drastic. But anything that we're finding difficult to do. I love that metaphor that you've used, that start filling your cup little by little. You don't have to take that big decision today. Dheere dheere karke, chote chote cheeze. And self-care wali cheezen karo. Yeah, very nice. Yes.
Ensure that while saying yes to somebody else, you're not saying no to yourself.
Wow. I like it. Yes. Yes. So
mantra.
Superb. So now if people are listening to this right now and they're feeling moved and they're saying, yes, I want to ignite that spark. How should they connect to you? What do you prefer? Should they mail you? Should they, you know, start spamming you on Instagram or like right here in messages? What would you prefer?
So they should get into my Insta DMs and let me know that they want to connect. That's a good way to get in touch with me.
Right.
They can also write to me at alpa@ignitethespark.in. I also am not an easy one. So I will give you a questionnaire and understand where you're at. You know, and there's, you know, there's lots of content which I have on YouTube as well.
Right.
So people want to go and see them. Lots of topics I have.
So I'm going to link that right here. So you can actually go and check her, you know, her channel out and go follow her as well, because that's what we need to do over here. Especially and more importantly, I think if you have any questions, those questions help us give you better content. So ask us what your question is. I will ask. I'll put it forth to Alpa. You can directly connect with her. All details will be mentioned right here. Sare bata denge. So good. So Alpa, now this month, you know, as we were discussing, we are next topic. What do you suppose should be? What should people look forward to that the next time we come around? What do we want to talk about?
So, you know, I see a lot of these energy leaks that we are doing, Shruti, is because we all think we are like, you know, multitaskers and we're like, oh, we are doing so many things together. I've realized in my experience as a coach, while we are trying to do many tasks, we are actually wearing many masks.
Masks.
So we are changing, we are changing ourselves in every relationship, in every job to be somebody different. And when the same person is trying to be five things, it's like that Harry Potter's Horcrux, right? It just depletes the energy out.
Oh, wow. You've thrown Harry Potter in. Now we need to come next time definitely and discuss all the masks with you. That's very interesting. Good. So if you right now while listening, you said masks, I have a couple of questions about that. For sure, reach out to us, DM us on Instagram. The way to reach us is written right here. So you can reach out and we will see you the next time. Alpa, for today, thank you so much. This was a wonderful discussion. It's totally ignited my brain and my energies towards you. So I think half the job is done right there. Thank you.
It is, absolutely. Thank you, Shruti. It was a pleasure speaking with you.
See you next time. Bye.